Howdy. Well, Russ here.
And Devilish Chris again.
Devilish Chris. You're going to get us canceled, man. First, Lil Nas X is getting canceled, and now you're trying to cancel us, man. With all jokes aside, what do you think of his new video? Montero.
Well, we first watched this on Sunday night, so this whole thing that we're doing has been fermenting for 3 days now, because we haven't done anything.
Well, we actually filmed.
Twice.
Yeah, but we actually reacted to the song, and we're like, dude, I don't want to deal with copyright or getting blocked. I just don't want to deal with that right now.
Yeah, it's like, it's never going to go out if we do it with that. So we filmed it, and then like didn't use it, and then we went back and just like watched the video again without the music on, and talked about it, and then we're like, okay, we're not going to post that either. So now we're just talking.
And the initial reaction to it, I mean, it was visually entertaining.
And
of course,
creepy.
Creepy at the same time. And you could tell he was trolling. You know, Lil Nas X is the master troll. He knew that we would all be talking about it.
So and if you're going to make some money, you better have people talking about you.
I mean, he has to make money to pay for that expensive video. Yeah. That was a high budget.
That was a high
okay,
budget.
So what was it? The Garden of Eden, and then a snake with a third eye tempts him, and then they start making out.
I know. I don't like it was kind of creepy watching him like make out with the snake, which was, I've not heard anyone say this. I think every one of those characters was him.
Yeah. I think people did say that.
Oh, okay. See, I haven't seen anyone say that, but I am pretty sure
we're late.
All of them were him.
We're late.
So he's making out with himself.
Yeah, I mean, it's not really that weird. Okay, so anyways, he makes out with a snake, and then he goes under, like, judgment. And there were the creepy, like, Hunger Games characters.
Yeah.
And he had, like, the cotton candy hair. Then the people get outraged in the courtroom and stone him to death, and he dies. He kind of, like, rose up in the sky and then fell.
Yeah.
And then he became a pole dancer. And his pole dancing skills were freaking amazing.
He's a pretty good pole dancer.
And he has a nice body. And, of course, he was showing his box. You can see his box, like, bumping on all over the screen. And, you know, I'm like, okay, I'm an adult.
See, I just didn't see that part of it. You kept talking about his box, and I, like, never paid any attention to his box.
I will make sure there's a picture.
He's got a good body.
He's got a good body. But do you want, like, little kids watching this?
No, that would be the thing. You said this was trending, and I don't know. I haven't watched it. It's still trending, and if kids have access to it, it's kind of creepy looking. I mean, the visuals were well done, but they were creepy since I grew up in church and, like, had some of these, like, fears of hell and damnation and all of that is like, so it was like creepy. they did it well.
It was creepy.
It creeped
and
me
then
out.
Of course he went to hell and he seduced the devil and he gave the devil like an epic lap dance and the devil was like, oh man, like I'm seduced, which is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
I mean,
instead
usually
of the devil,
seducing
him,
he seduced the devil.
And then the big thing is like, then he killed the devil, just broke his own neck.
And then became the devil.
Became whatever it was. I don't know. Or maybe he just became.
He took the crown.
He took the crown. So he became like the ruler of whatever, the underworld. I don't know.
So before we get into the shoes.
But he beat the devil.
Yeah. And he also had
his own gig.
Yeah. He had shoes to go along with this whole video. But we'll get into the shoes in a second. The concept of the video at first, I mean, I didn't quite understand all of it. I just thought it was more him trolling. And then we actually watched the breakdown of his lyrics. And of course, it was like him meeting up with a guy, I'm paraphrasing his lyrics, he was meeting up with a guy, and the guy was doing a bunch of sketchy things, like maybe some drugs, but it was worth
drugs.
The hookup. He was like, hey, you do you, and I'll do me.
And I'm just here for the hookup.
And then, of course, the movie reference, Call Me By Your Name, which I've seen.
We've seen.
It's good.
Yeah.
It's a good movie overall.
Go watch Call Me By Your Name. Probably everyone has now.
It's a lot more romantic, though, than this song. This song is really trolly.
Yeah.
I mean, to be associated with the movie, it's like the movie is actually like well done and very artsy, but it inspired Lil Nas X to make this song part of the reasons. And the other thing that inspired him is he was a gay guy growing up in a Christian church. And just to be real, a lot of the verses in the Bible and a lot of Christians, not all of them, but a lot of Christians do not think gay people that choose to continue to live as a gay person are going to heaven.
No, it's like you've got all those verses about you're condemned to hell. And so I think he was trolling with this, just like, okay, this is what you've been telling me all my life, or this is what you told me when I was a kid. And like, I'm not able to change being gay. So this is what you've told me. So I'm just going to show you what you've told me. Basically, is what I think it is now. So I was creeped out about it to begin with. But then when I think what he's really doing is just showing them the story that they told him about himself. That's all he's doing.
He's kind of trolling.
Giving the story back to them.
He's trolling what they said was going to happen to him.
Yeah.
Like, literally, it's what, like, a lot of Christians think is going to happen to us.
Yeah.
Have you ever in your life had a Christian tell you that you are going to hell because you choose to be gay? Or choose to live as a gay man, even though you were born gay, but you choose to embrace who you really are?
Yeah. I mean, you hear that even as a kid before you come out, before you're trying to figure out, like, even before you know what the words are for what you're feeling and that sort of thing. But you hear the verses in the Bible, because I was one of the kids that listened to people when they talked in church. I wasn't, like, playing under the benches and stuff like some of the other kids were.
You were
scared.
I was
listening. I was scared. I was freaked out.
The verses that say,
a good little angelic boy.
Oh, yeah, you were. You were not good and angelic. You shot your grandma with a BB gun in the butt. Just saying. I know you were little, and I know you didn't know any better, but still, like, you weren't completely angelic.
That's, like, the only bad thing I did.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. But you remember verses like,
if a man lies with a man, is with a woman, they should be put to death. It's like, ooh, that was,
and
like,
it's
gonna
in
kill
the
me.
Old and the New Testament. Yeah. And I always thought it was just in the Old Testament, but it's in the New Testament too. And it's like, that's scary. Lil Nas X probably grew up his whole life thinking that if he chose to live his life as a gay man and he couldn't get rid of those feelings because it is who he is, he was probably going to go to hell.
Well,
and
I don't know if he believed it. I mean, maybe he did, maybe he didn't. I don't know if we really get that out of this, but he's just depicting what he was told, what these verses mean. And so I think that's really what he's doing. He's, I think, decided that that's not the case, because I think he was kind of like showing, you know, I'm going to beat the devil at the own game here. You know, you've given me the devil. You've given me this option. I'm going to beat it.
Yeah.
I think that's really what ultimately he was doing.
Do you notice that the song lyrics say nothing about the devil?
No, it's like the video really has not anything to do so much with the music itself.
And it's
but
one
that's true
song.
Of a lot of videos
yeah, yeah,
these
yeah,
days.
Yeah, definitely. And I don't think the song was that good. It was like literally a D, maybe, okay, I'll give it a C minus quality song, because it definitely had a lot of production value. But as far as like being good, it wasn't as good as Old Town Road. Old Town Road was like epic.
It's this not an Old Town Road.
Without the music video being trolling,
video. Yeah.
It would just not do anything. The song would just be like, okay, it's another song. But with the video and the outrage and the people like...
And the controversy
and
over
the controversy.
Shoes, we can start talking about that now. So apparently they had this company, this other company, take a Nike shoe and make a shoe with a 666 on it. And then the verse about, and I saw Satan be cast down to the earth or cast out of heaven or what have you. So yeah, there. So it's an altered shoe. And they made only 666 pair of them, I guess. And I'm like, how did they know what sizes to make if they're only going to make 666 pair of shoes? You know, how many? But then they sold out in a minute. So how did they know the size of the shoes of the feet of the people that were going to buy these 660? I wonder if it's like, did they really make 666 pair? Or is that just part of the whole trolling storyline here? Because they're getting a lot of publicity out of it. But the same company had made a Jesus shoe before, what, in 2019?
Yeah, I could pull it up. We could actually figure it out, but I think it was 2019. But of course, nothing happened.
No one
happened.
Cared about the Jesus shoe.
Well, I mean, Nike didn't care.
Nike didn't care.
And no. It wasn't ever Nike that actually made these. It was another company that made them. And then Nike didn't sue when this other company made the Jesus shoes.
Oh, the Jesus shoes had a steel crucifix and holy water source from the Jordan River in the shoe, whereas these devil shoes has a pentagram on it there, and then, of course, the verse, and, like, there's a drop of human blood.
It looks like he copied the design.
Anyway, it's just like, he's just totally like, okay, if you can do it this way, then
he changed the color. He put blood instead of holy water. Instead of a cross, he put that.
Yeah.
I mean, and the thing is, this is technically not satanic. Well, maybe the symbol is.
That symbol is satanic.
But this is a biblical verse. Like, there might be preachers that actually say this verse in church. So in some ways, this is actually referencing the Bible.
So this is not like a verse that was taken out of the satanic Bible, whatever that is.
He missed out. He should have done that.
It was taken out of the Bible. And I mean, I grew up being freaked out by 666, you know, because I heard all of that in church. And I think... That is one of the things that, to me, this brings out. It's like so many people, and not all churches, But there are churches out there that focus more on the devil and the scare tactics of hell and everything than they do even about Jesus, I think.
Can I be real?
Christ.
Most churches that I've ever been to, I only hear of churches that are like positive to gay people, and it's because they choose not to interpret the Bible 100%.
Yeah.
It's because they're looser on it. They're like, hey, the Bible's not all 100% literal. A church that is literal and takes the Bible as truth 100%, they're most likely not going to like gay people.
Or they're not going to believe that it's okay if you choose to live your life as a gay person.
They're definitely not going to think that me and you being a married couple are going to heaven.
Yeah.
So what is the alternative?
Their story is you go to hell.
So I literally have had Christians, and not all of them, my mom's Christian, she's awesome. I've had Christians, one at the gym, a couple times actually, two different guys, but one guy was like, hey, he was trolling. He said I had a nice body, which is kind of weird. I was like, okay, that's kind of odd. And then he's like, because I was working out or whatever, and then he's like, oh, and then he mentioned some other things like, do I have a girlfriend? I was like, no, I have a boyfriend. And he's like,
because at that time he only had a boyfriend. And then, he didn't have a husband.
Then he tried to get me to pray it away. And then when I said, hey.
Like standing right there, he wanted you to pray it away or something?
No, he just told me I need to pray it away. Pray it away. I need to find Jesus and I need to change my heart. Otherwise, I'm going to hell.
Okay.
And I was like, that's pretty freaking harsh to say to me. He's like, you just met me and you were the one who like initiated like complimenting my body. Like, what the F?
Yeah, it's like,
which is kind of weird already. Maybe he's dealing with internalized homophobia too. I don't know. But essentially, I have heard from Christians that I'm going to hell because me being gay.
Yeah.
So what's my alternative? So if I troll on going to hell, is that any worse than them telling me I'm going to hell?
You know, I think that's what Lil Nas X was doing.
I
think that might be something with, I mean, I didn't hear Lil Nas X saying this, but okay, so he was in the more feminine color, in the pink with like the, what'd you call it, cotton candy colored hair. But cotton candy can be more than
pink.
One
it was
color,
a pink.
But it was pink hair. And then all the others that were in Judgment were in blue. But they were kind of pretty feminine,
yeah,
even though they're in blue. And they're doing the Judgment.
Bluish gray.
So, I mean, whether he meant for it to be or not, I think that's a good, what would it be, metaphor or allegory? I can't remember which one.
Hasn't masculine colors switched over time?
Yeah, they have.
That's not what I'm talking about. Keep going.
What I was trying to say is like, okay, when you think about a lot of the people, guys that come out and they're like so anti-gay, and like, they're the ones that are end up, and politicians, a lot of them too, politicians in particular, that are hiding their internal homosexuality and they're like so against gay, they're self-hating gays. They're loathing them on their own self. So I think maybe that was something he was depicting there, this, you know, all those in Judgment of him were those that are like actually hiding.
So what do you think of Nike suing this other company that helped Lil Nas X make the shoe?
Well,
it does look like a Nike sign. So, I mean, like,
I think
it's
a Nike shoe. They just altered the Nike shoe from what I understand.
I think they had the right to sue him. I just don't think that Nike has the highest platform to like stand on because they've been like known to have like slave labor kind of thing.
Yeah, so that's
like not
that's
the best
thing.
Working conditions.
It's like in our society now, we're all talking about this song and the controversy or what have you, but probably what we should be talking about instead
is who's like, making our products. Yeah. Where are they made? How are they treated?
Yeah. What are these people going through that are making all these products that we're using? And usually they don't even want us to know who's making the products. I mean, we watched a video on cell phones.
Ooh.
It's like just $1 difference in the chemicals they use in cleaning the cell phones after they're manufactured. They use this terrible chemical that causes cancer. And people in China are dropping dead like flies.
And I don't know what phone company it was. I don't know.
I think it's just phones in general because most of them are made there. But if they'd use a different chemical, it wouldn't be causing cancer in the Chinese workers that are basically enslaved in some of these places.
Dude,
so
who pays $1,000 for shoes?
That's the other thing. It's like,
if you have that kind of money, what the frick?
During COVID, I mean, here we are after COVID. People have lost everything or about to lose things. You know, maybe people even lose their home when they lift the ban on what is it, evictions from your home? you know, if you haven't been able to pay your mortgage or what have you. So, you know, whenever that's lifted, people are going to be kicked out of their homes and people, you know, haven't had funds. And we're worried about this when someone has the ability to pay. I would be ashamed to pay $1,000 and something for these pair of shoes. That's the biggest thing. It's like, okay, to each his own, but I do not get paying $1,000 for these shoes.
You know,
it's more than $1,000.
You know how bad press is good press? Even though Nike decides to like sue Lil Nas X,
yeah, no press
it's ultimately probably just going to help the company.
Yeah, and it's going to, like, ultimately, yeah, he's going to get canceled by some people. But
and then some people are going to want to support them more for their decisions. I 100% support Lil Nas X's right to do that video. It doesn't bother me at all. He can express himself how he wants to, and it's not the way I would.
Yeah. I wouldn't have made that video. I would have never thought of making that video.
I thought it was well done, but I mean, it's not my style. That's
it
not
was
the way.
Creative.
I mean,
he is a creative guy.
I think back to like, well, even my mother, I'm like, is my mom going to be offended by this? And I think she would. And I don't want to offend my mom.
I was freaked out by it.
You know, my mom's pretty cool though. Like my mom had to leave the church though to support me. Mm-hmm. So I don't think that people really understand what's going on in his head. Like mm-hmm. Lil Nas X.
No, we have more of an idea
because
of probably some of the thoughts he had.
Because we were raised in the church.
Yeah.
And we were gay or bi. And then...
I was gay. Gold star.
You have all these like thoughts and even suicidal thoughts because everyone around you says that you're an abomination. Yeah.
But then
you're
the big thing
hell.
When you think about that, it's like, okay, like, God, I'm like gay and they're telling me I'm going to go to hell anyway. And it's like... I can't even get out of this. If I commit suicide, I'm just in hell quicker. You know,
yeah.
it's like that's
no winning.
There's no winning in this situation. And
he won though. Lil Nas X killed the devil.
He killed the devil.
Why aren't Christians happy about this?
I don't know. I think they're missing that part. He like conquered the devil. So like when he's got these wings and everything, does that mean that like should we really be interpreting that some other way? He's now angelic. He killed the devil. I don't know. It's not something I would have made, but oh well, he's done it. I don't personally have a problem with it. Now, if I had kids, I wouldn't necessarily be so cool about them seeing the video because what he was depicting is what terrified the you know what out of me as a little gay kid.
But you got to admit, saw pictures
like,
in church.
It would, but the stories, here's where I saw those same kind of images, were in the little
tracks. What images?
Of like, someone's going to go to hell type of thing. I was terrified by the little tracks. I meant
to
look those. The little pamphlets.
Okay,
did
that's
you
better.
Never see these little
pamphlets?
They're called tracks, religious tracks.
Okay, I didn't know that.
And there's a certain company that put them out. I can't remember, but they're always depicting the devil. And he's like, you know, people like being thrown into hell and all this. They were terrifying. I was freaked out by seeing those things. And he just put it in color and put it on the screen.
But it's not okay when he does it.
But it's not okay when he does it.
Yeah.
But those tracks were laying on the church benches in so many churches that I went to.
Well,
me tell you.
We've had them sent to us
and
before.
We have one somewhere.
Yeah, we've had them sent to us by Christians saying that we're going to burn in hell if we don't change.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, they literally sent us some of those scary images that Lil Nas X did.
I wish I knew how to research which company made those things, because they were ubiquitous. They were everywhere in the South, and I'm sure they still are.
Okay, so when it comes down to it, I don't know if kids should be able to see it, because, for one, it was very sexual. And, yeah, I don't want my nieces necessarily seeing this. I don't think... it's fair that YouTube's promoting it.
So it's like one of the other big things that this just like puts out there in front to me is there's not a level playing field for creators.
Yeah.
If you're with a big label, you can create just about anything you want to and make tons of money on it. But if you're a small creator, they seem to like have the algorithms watching you like hawks.
Yep.
And you can't say anything or do anything.
Okay, now the last thing that I want to add is this video wasn't really that crazy. Like, when it really comes down to, like, comparing it to other things, like video games of people, like, blasting each other and killing each other with guns, or even other music videos with a lot of violence or gang activity or, like, war movies or just... I mean, there's other movies out there, like Little Dicky that involve the devil, and they make jokes around it, but they're not getting canceled. There are so many crazy things out there. There's comedians out there that say controversial things. They're just playing and poking on things. We can't cancel everybody.
No.
We just have to let people disagree sometimes. And you should just have to know that, like, hey, you have to know that sometimes you're not going to agree with somebody. It's okay. Yeah. It's okay not to agree 100% of the time.
Don't cancel those over here or over there. Believe in freedom of speech and expression. I think we should have freedom of religion or non-religion and freedom of expression.
Mm-hmm. What do you all think of this? Wyorus.
And Chris. Love you long time.
If you made it this far in this video, thank you so much. Consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell. We also have a Patreon page and merchandise. Consider supporting us. Thank you so much. Love you.